श्री पराशक्ति विद्याला CBSE क्लास 8 स्टैंडर्ड सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर।
गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। 8th स्टैंडर्ड कंप्यूटर साइंस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द सेकंड लेसन कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड अप टू द ट्रांजिशन मीडियम। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी दिस एलैबोरेटली। Transmission medium, it is used for network communication. The first one is the coaxial cable. The coaxial cable is an electrical cable covered by an insulating layer conductor made up of flexible material. The insulating layer is also covered by a conductive layer made up of copper wire and covered on the outside with a thin insulating layer. In the diagram you can see everything. Here is the copper wire and here it is the insulating material and here copper mesh, next outside also insulating layer. The next one, coaxial cable over, next one twisted pair cable. It is a commonly used medium for networking and it is very easy to use and cheap in the cost. It is a type of wiring, you see here, in which two conductors of single circuit are twisted together. The twisted pair cancel out the electromechanical interference. So it is a thin flexible cable used for network communication. Next one is the optical fiber cable. The optical fiber cable you see here in this figure. It is capable of containing one or more plastic fibers. They are coated with plastic layers. It consists of a core and a cladding layer selected for total reflection. They are used for long distance communication or for high speed data connection between different parts of the building. Okay, now we see the infrared radiation. It is not visible to us. Humans can sense it as heat. The light you see with our eyes is very small portion of what is called the electromagnetic spectrum. The infrared waves are lower energy and less harmful. So these are used for security and military purposes. Okay, is it clear about the transmission medium? Okay, the next one is the advantages of networking. In this, first one, data sharing. It is the easiest way to share the data across the world through the internet. Here multiple users can share the information and the resources at the same time over the network. The second one is the reliability. Reliability means what? If your computer in a network fails to work, other system can easily work. Using that we can do the work easily. Okay, next one is the security. A network provides security by ensuring that only the authorized users can access to the files and the application. That is the security. Other person, they should not use the files and applications. Next one, efficiency. A network is said to be efficient if any modification, upgradation and deletion of data or software is done at a single point only. So efficient hand we are saying. Here efficiency of the network means modification, any corrections, any upgradations, that is addition of record or deletion of record, data, software, that can be done very easily using a single point. Next, less hardware cost. The hardware used in the network are printers, scanners, modems. So, for a network, only one printer enough. and one scanner, one modem enough. No need to have for each computer, no need to have printer, scanner, modem separately. So this reduces the cost of the hardware equipment. Next one, efficient use of storage media. The network allows us to store a shareable application data on a server. It helps to avoid the storage of copy of data on each user's computer. So no need to store the data on every computer. We can share the data from the server only. Okay. Next, applications of networking. You all know applications. Applications means where we are using the network, we are going to study now. First one, electronic messaging. Electronic messaging means email, electronic mail, you all know very well. You can send and receive the messages to one another in any part of the world by using the email. Next one, electronic data interchanging. Electronic data interchanging means EDI. It is the method of transferring the data over the network. For the business purposes, it is very, very useful. And the next one is teleconferencing. What do you mean by teleconferencing? It allows the people to exchange and share the ideas with each other without being present at the same place. No need to sit in one place and share your ideas. At a different parts of the world, you can be there and we can conduct the conferencing. The teleconferencing is of two types. One is the video conferencing and another one is the voice conferencing. Video conferencing, you can see as well as talk to one another. But voice conferencing, you can do only voice communication simultaneously over the phone. At the same time, more than one person can talk. There, you can talk as well as see in video conferencing. Next one is marketing and sales. You all know the meaning of marketing and sales. The networks are used extensively in both marketing and sales organizations. Professionals use them to exchange and analyze the data relating to the customer needs. Based on the needs of the customer, data can be analyzed and also you can exchange. Next, electronic funds transfer. Electronic funds transfer, here EFT. That is, you can transfer the money without going to the bank through online. Is it clear to all? Okay, these are all the applications of networking. Now we pass on to the types of network. What are the different types of network? First one is personal area network. Shortly, we can call this as PAN. Next, local area network, that is LAN. Next, metropolitan area network, MAN. Next one, wide area network, WAN. Next, cluster area network, that is CAN. Okay, these are all the five types of network. Now we will see this one by one. First one, PAN, personal area network. Here the devices can be computers, mobile phones, printers, hubs, etc. In the figure you see printer, laptop, smartphone, mobile and also the PC. They are connected within few meters radius. Okay, the devices in the PAN can be connected to each other using the cable or wireless links, that is Bluetooth. You all know you are sharing, that is transferring the sounds from the laptop to mobile phone and mobile to another mobile using the Bluetooth, that is wireless link. Okay, yeah? Next, local area network, LAN. Here you see in this figure, all the client systems are connected here and here is the hub and switch and here we are having the server. This is about 1 kilometer. Within 1 kilometer, we can have the network, that is known as the local area network. This is usually installed in the company building, school or campus. It consists of central server that is connected to several other computers. This is the central server. These are all other computers. They are connected using the hub. So each computer in the lab in a school has separate LANs. Okay, now we pass on to the metropolitan area network, that is MAN. This type of network spans about a few kilometers. Few kilometers means 20 kilometers, 10 kilometers, 60 kilometers, like this. Here they are installed in different branches of an office in the same city. Within the city, we can have the metropolitan area network. See the figure also. Next one, wide area network. This type of network spans about thousands of kilometers, that is through the entire world. Here the internet is considered to be the network of computers in the world, and they are called as WAN, WAN, wide area network. Here it can span countries and also even continents. Here you see the figure given here. Next one, cluster area network or campus area network. Here campus area network, they are having different LANs. It is smaller than the metropolitan area network. Here university or local business campuses, this can be, we can see. It is also known as the campus area network. Now we pass on to the homework. Listen children, you all read up to this type of network and try to do the book exercise. And known answer you write. At the end of this lesson, we will discuss the answers also. Okay. Thank you, students.